So now we will go through several types of multiprocessors. The first type of multiprocessor uses what is called a centralized shared memory. So all the cores, let's say we have four of them, might have their own caches, but then they're all connected to the same bus, so they can all access the same main memory and input-output devices. These cores can share data by simply reading and writing the main memory, assuming, of course, that these reads and writes go through the caches properly, and we will see that we can achieve that. So pretty much this core can send data to this core by writing to some memory location, and then this core reads it from there. Similarly, any of the cores can access any of the I/O devices here. This type of a system is really what today's multi-core processors tend to look like, and is also called YUMA, which stands for Uniform Memory Access Time. But it's not UMAT, it's just YUMA, but what is uniform is really the time to access the memory. Why? Well, because this main memory is at the same long distance from all of the cores. Yes, it can be slightly closer to some of them, but because they're all connected to it in the same way, the memory really is about as bad to access as any one of them. This type of multiprocessing is also called SMP, which stands for symmetric multiprocessor. It's called symmetric because any core and its cache look just like any other core and its cache in the system. So if we had two cores, we can just take one of them with its caches and replicate to make a four-core system.